Let's dive deep into the water. We'll find pearls, we'll cost a dollar. Yeah, don't you know? It's now or never. It's now and ever. It's now and never. Yeah, I'm feeling lucky this time. Do or die, let's give it a try. We're on fire, so tell me what you're waiting for. So tell me what you're waiting for.
This year we've offered students something a little bit different. We've come up to Scotland, the Scottish Highlands, to the Allerdale Wilderness Reserve, where students have the opportunity to look around, see the mountains, see the wildlife, and make a film, a documentary, which covers every aspect of the park.
My name is Ed Vaughan, I'm 13 years old and I've been a student in BFA for about 4 years now.
I'm James Goldsmith and I'm 13 years old.
I'm Troy, I'm 14 and I'm a student of BFA.
I'm Amara, I'm 13 and I'm a student.
My name is Ellie, I'm 11 years old and I'm a BFA student.
My name is Lucy, I'm 12 years old and I'm a student of BFA.
I'm Grace, I'm 11.
My name is Jane Gisran, I'm 14 years old, and we've come here to film a documentary in the Scottish Highlands.
Documentary about animals and also having a lot of fun.
We've been filming wildlife, we've seen deer, we've seen lots of different species of bird. We've also filmed rivers, mountains, and we've actually experienced not only the activities, we've been out and we've trekked, we've gorge walked, and we've also tried to take a bit of time to reflect, sit back and try and take in the scenery around us. What I think has been really important is that the students have effectively gone off grid. They've not been using their phones at all, so they're a little bit put off by this at the beginning. They found it quite difficult, but we're now day four and I think they're really enjoying it. I think they're enjoying having a bit of peace, a bit of reflection, and understanding that it's not all about looking at your iPhone and spending so much time on social media.
I've never been to Scotland before, so that's really exciting, but I'm also here for the film aspect since I'm into filmmaking.
We're making a documentary on the wildlife and the plants, and we've set up badger traps to try and get some footage of badgers. Well, we have to like include the plants, the landscape, the animals, and like we have to do some interviews like I'm on now.
We're making documentaries about the wildlife here and the threats to species like badgers.
So here we have one of the camera traps, and that's trying to point at the hole, which is the badger's hole, and they like live there. And then we put one here so that we can see when it like comes out and when it runs away.
They've been explaining to us all the work they're doing here, how they're now trying to protect endangered animals like badgers, and we're trying to find one tonight.
This morning we went tree planting uphill in Scotland, and we planted willows. And it will take about 10 years for it to properly grow. Kicked around, displaced by feet. All our broken stones. You're out trying to get home. Like a loser's reach.
Too slow and short to hit the peaks. The nature and the wildlife around us, and the opportunity to work alongside some groups that are really enthusiastic about being here, so tree planting, ecology work. It's a really special place to work actually. It's really cool, very lucky to be here.
The role of a BFA mentor on this trip is to really aid and assist the children in their filmmaking process on on their trip to Allerdale. So some of the things I've been doing in my role is suggesting certain ideas, shot types, especially with the editing that we've been getting along and doing within the evening and the next day, and talking about plans and scripts, which is incredibly important, I feel, and it's really using the expertise we have benefited from and really teaching the children just in the way that I've been taught by other mentors in the past.
The students making films, but also they're being here, they're tree planting, they're doing peat bog surveys, they're just getting involved as well. So not only are they promoting, they're going to put on social media, they're going to inspire their friends, inspire a new generation, get them involved in conserving conservation of our wildlife.
We've kind of integrated filmmaking with ecology. We think it's really important at Barnes Film Academy to stress kind of important messages, and film's a great communicator of messages. So we've really been stressing the importance of conservation, particularly here in Scotland. There's massive issues here with kind of deforestation, global warming and that sort of thing. So it's great to have the kind of future generations, the kids who are making these films, to kind of seem to be kind of not just telling the stories about it, but also able to be involved in kind of pre-production, production and post-production to really kind of communicate the important messages about ecology.
The European Nature Trusts are the lead sponsors of the Barnes Film Festival, and for us the most exciting part of this partnership was being able to show the films the guys are creating this week at this year's Barnes Film Festival. For us it makes it all worthwhile. We'll see the guys come up, we'll see the guys journey through the reserve and make films, and then those films will be screened to friends and family back in London, and we're really excited to see everyone there this September.
I'm a lot more aware of my surroundings.
And hopefully it'll open the eyes of people in the city so they may stop cutting down trees.
This has helped me see the problems that they're facing here in Scotland. So it's definitely helped me understand better
how important the reforestation is.
I certainly respect the wildlife a lot more. I think people don't often appreciate what's around them. Until they've really gotten away from technology, and when they're kind of forced to, you know, appreciate their surroundings.
This place should be protected because there's not many places like this left in the world.
Even though the water was freezing cold, it was still really fun to learn some information as we climbed up the gorge.
It was really fun because we kind of did it as a team, and we made it up quite a fast river.
Setting up the badger traps, and I'm really looking forward to see if we get any footage.
We had to find a spot in the woods where we could sit by ourselves in silence and to get away from nature and from technology and become one with nature more.
The scenery and just getting away from London and just having a bit of peace and quiet.
Climbing the mountain and coming down again, that was lots of fun.
I've seen a lot more than I ever thought I would.
Yeah, I've never really done much of this before, like the tree planting, that was cool. It's like you made an impact on the environment.
In three words to sum up this trip, I'd probably go with fascinating,
different,
exciting,
amazing, green,
interesting,
fun, difficult,
relaxing,
windy,
exciting,
fun,
fantastic,
exciting,
cold,
and interesting,
intriguing.
How amazing it is!